I give up. Ya Allah, I'm completely submitting it to you. I'm submitting my affairs to you, Ya Allah. And what did the angels say, subhanAllah, according to some of the riwayat? Say, Sawtun Ma'ruf. That's a familiar voice calling out in Makan and Gharib. But what an unfamiliar place that he's calling out from. That's a familiar voice. A man who used to call out to Allah frequently. But what an unfamiliar place that we're hearing the voice of the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from. In the bottom of an ocean, in the middle of nowhere, in the belly of a huge whale. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. Dear brothers and sisters, at that point when Yunus alayhi salam was swallowed at that whale, not because his people ran him out, but because he turned away from his people. SubhanAllah, this is unique from the Anbiya, unique from the Prophets. It was because of his mistake that he was in the belly of that whale in the first place. He put himself there. Allah Azza wa Jalla did not tell him to go to the ocean. This was not like the Prophet when he was ran out by his people, or the numerous stories of the thousands of prophets run out by their people. And he could have, at that point, said, who survives the belly of a whale? I'm done. I am done. Astaghfirullah. Khalas. That's it. I'm done. But subhanAllah, Allah says, had he not been from the musabbihin, had he not been from the people of tasbih that say subhanAllah, that admit the perfection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he would have been consumed in the belly of the whale, and that would have been the end of his story. Instead, what's the end of his story? The end of his story, فَجَتَبَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَجَعَلَهُ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Allah chose him and made him better than before, and rose him up and made him from the righteous. What's the end of his story? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, لا يقولن أحدكم إني خير من يونس بن متى. Not one of you say that I am better than Yunus ibn Matta, than Yunus alayhi salam. Of course, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not like when people would do mufadha, would talk about the virtues of prophets over others. Don't belittle Yunus alayhi salam. Don't speak badly about Yunus alayhi salam. فَجَتَبَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَجَعَلَهُ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Look what became of him. Look what Allah Azza wa Jal made of him. But dear brothers and sisters, is there really any moment that you can think of where you could be lonelier or more desperate than Yunus alayhi salam in the belly of that whale in those moments? Is there any moment that a human being could feel completely disconnected from, you know, what is he hearing? What is he hearing? What is he feeling? How's he even processing dua in the midst of all of that? But subhanAllah, look what Allah Azza wa Jal made of him. Now, what is the one point of the story that I want to get to? Because I said, after why, there's often إِلَىٰ أَيْن وَإِلَىٰ مَتَىٰ. Where to and when, Ya Allah? And we want to talk about where to. You have to let the whale spit you out wherever it's going to spit you out. What island is he going to end up on? What's the trajectory after that? SubhanAllah, you read the story of Yunus alayhi salam. What island is he going to be spit out on? Where is Medina? Where is it going to end up from here? And that's a difficult thing for us to do istislam to submit ourselves to. But if we submit ourselves to that, then it becomes easier to submit ourselves to the mata, to the when. Because we know that wherever the destination is, so long as we are from al-musabbihin wal-mustaghfirin, those that glorify Allah and those that seek the forgiveness of Allah, wherever the destination is, it's going to be a good destination. As long as we're doing our part of tasbih and istighfar, of glorifying Allah and seeking forgiveness. And so the when is then facilitated by that. First you plug in the destination, then you look at how long it's going to take you. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our destination Jannat al-Firdaus, the highest level of Jannat al-Firdaus. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all of those that have buried their loved ones and whose lives have been completely uprooted by these untimely deaths. And I say untimely because Allah knows these times. Allah Azza wa Jalla knows best. We don't curse time. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will place you in a better destination. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deliver all of us bidnillahi ta'ala to a better destination. But we have to do istislam to that where, submit ourselves to that, to Allah Azza wa Jalla with the where, and let the whale take us wherever it will be. Be passengers in the belly of the whale in those moments, and just make sure that we are a people of La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. And by the way, that applies to everything that's taking place right now. Political instability and uncertainty.